Camera speed, set, and action.
Today we're going to be filming a teaser for Long Live Dick Parker. We're also going to be testing a new pipeline with Ghostframe in inner frustrum only.
We use advanced mathematics to alternate between those frames of chroma and the environment final pixel.
In this particular case, we've developed a method that allows us to basically keep that flickering only in the frustum of the camera.
This is the first time that we have actually implemented this feature in a production setting.
It's a big experiment, but we hope this pipeline will change the workflow of VFX and virtual production.
We're in Atlanta at the Lux Machina Studio at Trilith. We're shooting a scene that takes place in North Carolina on an old tobacco farm.
We're actually building a physical set, so our actor will actually have a place to live and react to, and it's going to be accentuated by the virtual world outside.
A big part of this production is to marry the traditional physical world with like the new virtual tools that we have, and trying to make them as seamless as possible, and where they can't be seamless, using technology like Ghostframe to have like a plan B in post.
What Ghostframe is going to allow us to do is use practical, the virtual world that we've created as our backdrop, or change things however we want them to look with chroma key. We're shooting at 48 frames per second, and then in post, extrapolating that out into two 24 frames per second timelines. And one is going to have full chroma key, the other one is going to be practical, and it's going to have our scene as we've shot it.
Shooting at 48 frames per second obviously halves the time per frame that we can use, which actually reduces the motion blur. And the typical shutter angles for 24 frames per second would be 180 degrees. We're using modern cameras that have very fast shutter times. So we can change the shutter times to 270 degrees with 48 frames per second, which gives us something close to 135 degrees at a frame rate of 24. So it's a compromise that gives us a capability of Ghostframe while still allowing us to have a motion blur that it feels like a movie.
Cross moving.
When you're running Ghostframe on a volume this large, it can be incredibly overwhelming and cause actors and everyone working in there to be uncomfortable.
There are multiple ways to mitigate that flicker, but a lot of those can have implications for the shutter angle of the camera, and that's important to achieving this filmic look. So our way of dealing with this was by basically confining where we were actually doing the swapping in Ghostframe just to the frustum of the camera.
To isolate Ghostframe to the frustum, I built a blueprint that, based on the editor's role and the render's role, it would set the frustum to be blue screen on one cluster and the regular field of view on the other cluster. That way, we were able to swap back and forth on the processors to achieve having Ghostframe in just the frustum. After each take, I would push the shot down directly to nuke as well.
Over here, we've brought in a nuke team that can start slap comp immediately on stage as we're rolling takes in Unreal Engine and on our camera in close to real time.
One of the nuke artists wrote a script that would split the frames in the node graph, and that way he had the blue screen version and the Unreal Engine version, and we could directly composite and look at a good slap comp with correct reflections from the site on the shoot, and the result was amazing.
Ultimately, at the end of the day, it gives a lot of flexibility to production and makes post-production a lot easier.
It enables us to be able to make changes on the fly right here as we're filming, or all the way through to post-production. The entire process, we can make those changes. It really opens my mind to be creative in a completely different capacity.
Basically, the objective is to bring all these things together so everyone can create this new, exciting way of filmmaking.